Hi everyone, my name is Dee Dee and welcome to part 41 of Jaime Lannister to Oliver. Here he is, the Breton Templar, the vampiric mustache tweaked eyelining wearing red-eyed ponytail freak of nature. He's a bad boy. He's level 23, which doesn't make him quite so bad boy as you'd probably think. But he has a big axe. He has a staff, which he kind of puts away very fast. There it is. Ah, it's glowing. And yeah, part 41. So this is going to be a PvE episode. Firstly, before I go into that, I'll just say thank you so much to everyone who watches, supports, subscribes for this series. I enjoy making it, and I love the fact that you guys enjoy watching it. So, as always, if you can hit the like button, if you're enjoying it, then once we get to 20 likes, I'll make another episode. Equally, I have decided, per some feedback from various different sources, some people like PvE, some people like PvP. Therefore, what I'm going to do for tomorrow is release a PvP episode of Mr. Jaime Lannister to Oliver. And yeah, when that one gets to 20 likes, I'm going to make another episode of PvP. And when this one gets to 20 likes of PvE, I'll make another episode of PvE. There seems to be too many P and V's and E's and P's in my life. However, that way I figure if we kind of branch out and we're kind of making two series at the same time, the people who like player versus player or player versus computer, then it's all good. We're all happy. Player versus electronics. I don't even know what the E stands for. Tell me in the comments what the E stands for. That's weird. So, regardless, let's crack on. Jamie's looking badass. Yes, I reckon he is looking badass. He looks very distinguished, I've decided, with his staff. His glowy staff. So I'm gonna use the staff for a bit, I think. And we're in Rivenspire. We've literally just got here, so... Oh, we've got a whole world to explore, and that can only be a good thing. One thing I am going to do, and I don't really do too much with you guys, is I'm going to wander up to Trader's Rest. It's not because I want to have a rest. It's more that I figure... There is the Moncler bastards. Oh, the Moncler bastard! It's more that I consider... I want to do some crafting, because I haven't logged in, and some crafting would be good. Oh, I do love Jaime Lannister Oliver. He's such a bad boy. He really is. Get back! Get back! Thank you. He really has no problems. Just annihilating enemies. He's invincible! Oh dear. No, he's still dead. Is it up there or is it down here? If it's way up there, let's just go for it. We're going exploring Schema Rat! There's a freaking massive rat, a level 25 rat! Look at it! Look at the size of it! Look at it! What's going on with his face? It's got like, it looks like a bird's face. It's just weird. Seriously weird. Oh! Colin, get them! Get the rats, they're the same size as you! Stop being a wimp! Oh, the axe. No. Close the axe. I'm assuming Trader's Rest is at the level 25 rats. Come on now. Come on now, Bethesda. We don't want to fight rats when we're level 25. We want to fight beasts, wolves, trolls, not rats. Ah, there's a merchant. Trader's Rest. Ah, the Hispark set. Right, I just really, just quickly, I really don't do enough research with this guy, so I figure it's going to be a good time. We want to have a good time. Have I got a resto? I do. Let's. Heloise! Heloise's staff is pretty rubbish, to be fair. Increases enchantment charges by 150%. That can get stuffed. I know it's better, but I could have deconstructed it, but whatever. Whatever! I'm sure there'll be plenty more things down the line, and that's quite good. What else have I got? What else have I haven't done much research on? I really haven't done much research. It's embarrassing how much research Jamie Lannister and Oliver has done. What have you been doing, Jamie? It sounded like quite a lot of Prince Charles. Jamie, what are you doing? I think now I sound like Nelson Mandela. Anyway, I'm terrible at accents, as you can tell. what shall I research? What's this? All of, I've done about two. I haven't done many of that, but reinforced is generally a bit rubbish. But that is the next one, really. I've only done one of those. Let's do one of those. The Clag Murtag Leggings. Yeah, why not? And where is the old black smithing? Done loads of those for some reason. Loads of those for some reason. And none of those. Well, that makes sense. The girdle is. And off we go. What the? What is that noise? Did you guys hear that noise? There was some like freaky badass noise. It's a question. Moira's hope! Moira!
You stomp around like a wounded guar.
Do you
want the enemy to eat us?
Well, I'm sorry. I just leapt off that rock down to there. Did you not see me? And anyway, they're just blood fiends. Who cares about them?
Get down, you fool. Do you want the blood fiends to see us? Now hush, hush. Medusa needs her ears right now. No, wait. Strike that. Let's talk. You can help Medusa, yes?
Yeah, I don't really help cats very much though, and you seem to have a vampiric tinge to you. Can you get a vampiric cat? Right, think about this. As a vampire, your incisors grow so you can bite stuff, but you're a cat, so you've already got really big incisors. So do you end up like a saber-toothed cat because you've got such big incisors? Is that kind of question you're looking for? Can we talk about that? No?
What kind of help?
Oh, you want help.
The helpful kind, of course. I meant to arrive before evil invaded this hamlet, find Constable Maldred, and provide what help I could. But this one was detained, and the constable is nowhere to be seen. Moira's hope is lost.
No! Moira's hope! Right, so we want to find Constable Maldred, is it? Presumably. Is that what you want me to do?
Patience. Adusa will explain.
Really?
The survivors. They are our priority.
Yes.
We move together to... No.
Where's Nono?
Yes.
Oh.
We move separately. Draw less attention that way. Adusa noticed a few survivors headed toward the large barn in the distance. Meet me there.
Yes. I'll meet you at the barn, you freaky red-eyed cat woman.
You go first. Then Adusa shall sneak off. Less chance of both of us getting captured by these cursed creatures that way.
I'm pretty sure you're going to get me to do all the work, though, aren't you? You're just going to turn up at the barn. The barn's just like round the corner, but I'm going to go all the way around the village. And yes, I'll see you there. Good little Adusa. Right then, let's check out these blood fiends. Do you think they're bad boy? I don't think they're bad boy. Let's have one of those. Oh, wrong one. Whoa! How did you get there? What the speck was that? Oh, they're jumpy bastards! They're like spiders! Not very tough spiders, in fairness. What? Get back! That was a bit weird for a moment. Hey, blood fiend. Ah. I'm a vampire killing undead people. My morals are conflicted. I'm unsure if I should be helping them or saving them or chewing on people's flesh with them. But I certainly don't know why I'm talking in this weird voice. Should I find the bomb? Yeah, whatever.
Stay back, vampire. I'll stick you with this sword. I mean it.
Okay.
Calm down, Shaveskin. Your courage is commendable, but highly misplaced. We are here to help.
Is she talking to me?
And how am I supposed to trust you?
This one could have overpowered you at any time.
That's true.
Now stand down, or Adusa will stick that sword where the bright moons never shine.
That's your ass.
How dare you? Oh, very well. I'll just go and sit down or something.
Right. Sit down, son. Right, Adusa, you freaky vampire cat woman.
Mortals, show a little concern, and this is the thanks you get. And where is the constable? Why isn't he here? But that is a mystery for another time. The survivors are our priority. Still, these vampires, they are most unusual.
He called you a vampire, and yet, well, he always referred to himself in the third person, and I'm a vampire, so, well, let's talk about vampires.
That is what I am, yes?
Yeah.
Surely you have learned by now that not every vampire is a monster. Adusa hopes that this doesn't make you uncomfortable. We still have survivors that need our assistance.
For what reason? Are we going to form a blood bank? Or something similar? I mean, I personally do actually consider myself a monster. I mean, I don't have any problem with that label. You are a bit of a freak if you're drinking other people's blood. And have you seen the length of your fingernails? Oh my goodness. They are freakish. I really think someone should buy you some nail clippers for Christmas, to be honest, because... Have you seen... How do you eat? If you're going to write something on a piece of paper, how do you do that?
Such precision.
Oh, okay.
Such coordination. Rarely have I seen vampires behave like an army instead of raiders. This wasn't an incursion. It was an occupation. We must work quickly. It won't take long for the enemy to discover our presence.
Okay, what's the plan? Adusa, you freaky
you stay
witch.
Here and guard these townsfolk. I'll go search for more survivors. No, no. Reverse that.
Yeah.
Better for you to search
yeah.
and Adusa to stay here.
You sit.
Watch for signs of the constable. I will try to learn more about our enemy while you are gone.
Signs of the constable? I'm sorry, but what does that look like? He calls you a vampire.
That is what I am,
yeah.
Yes.
Okay, well, I've already asked that. Good. Ooh, hello. I am relatively curious as to why... Alright, you're just going to go and sit there next to him, and I'm going to go and do the hard work. What a surprise. Who'd have thought? Couldn't even come with me, eh? Couldn't even come with me. Target is immune. Right, so I'm looking for survivors. Is anyone out there? Anyone need my help? Hi, Barry. That's a nice blockade you've made yourself there, my man.
I know how to deal with your kind. Come any closer and this goes straight into your heart.
Easy, pal. Just here to rescue you.
Perfectly safe right where I am. Thank you very much. I've got a sharp blade and plenty of food. I'm downright cozy.
Sounds nice.
Those bloodsuckers turn the townsfolk into their feral pets. Absolutely depressing. Divines, take them all.
Safer in the barn with the others. You know, safety in numbers and all that.
There are other survivors. Why didn't you say so?
I didn't ask.
I'll follow you, but we need to be very careful. These creatures aren't like any vampires I ever read or heard stories about. They're like a divine's damned army.
In fairness, mate, they could pretty much jump over that without too much problem at all. So, I think I'm doing you a favor. And your name is Thai Berry or something, which is a bit weird. Hello, I'm back. Any signs of the constable?
Vampire or blood fiend, you will fall to Adusa's terribly swift blades. Oh, it's just... Never mind then.
What? There's two of them. What? Is there a mirror? No. What?
So, where are the other survivors? Adusa doesn't see them. So that means you need to get back to the looking, yes?
Yes, you Russian cat.
That is all that Adusa asks. Is there something else you want to say?
You gave Thurbit a pretty good scare.
Sorry, but this one couldn't be too careful. Adusa had to dispatch the vampires that came sniffing around the barn. How was I supposed to know you want another wave of the vile creatures?
True. So who's this?
So, where are the other survivors?
I'm confused. Adusa's just multiplied. I can't work it out. Oh, I'm gonna ignore it. Maybe I don't know. It's a bit weird. Knock, knock. Oh, I don't even knock, I just walk in. I could be anybody and just walked into this person's house. Gonna steal all of their stuff in their cabinets and don't want to do that. Their logs, warm myself by the fire, maybe cook something. Oh, I can make some tea. Yeah, I don't do food. Don't interested in food. I'm a vampire, I drink blood. That's all I'm interested in. Blood. Yours, theirs, mine. Wow. Haven't you found the hiding spot? Is there anyone there? Oh yeah, look, there you are, Corwin.
Come on, let's have at it. I'd rather die fighting than get turned into one of your pitiful creatures.
Well, I wouldn't say I'm not one of them. I would just say I'm not with them, if that's all right. And I'm here to rescue you.
Well, that's a relief. I thought for sure you were going to kill me.
I might do anyway, further.
I just wish you had gotten here in time to save my father.
Oh, sorry, bro. What happened?
They called her Larea.
Hey?
She demanded that we line up to receive her blessing. That's
sorry.
What she called it, her blessing. My father was one of the first to step forward and tell her what to do with her blessing. She ripped out his throat.
Have you ever considered that might have been her blessing? She's a vampire after all, so kind of killing you, drinking your blood, turning you into one of her minions is generally what she would consider as a blessing.
Of course, you're right. I know you're right.
Yeah.
Lead the way.
Okay, let's go. And just for the record, that is not a good hiding place. Try, you know, a trunk under the bed. Kind of works well. Kids have been doing it for years. Even in there, in that cabinet. I mean, there's probably a cellar downstairs as well. Just saying, if there's ever a future vampire attack, which means you find yourself somewhat at risk of being massacred by a bunch of hungry blood fiends.
I don't want to die.
Oh, no, neither do I. Nobody does. It's one of those things. There's a dark anchor I can hear, which I'm going to have to go to in a minute. After I kill these fiends! Get back, you fiends! Oh!
An impressive show of combat prowess, stranger.
Why, thank you, my friend. I am Captain Combat. Hurrah! What's over there? I've got to rescue four more of these bros. Come on, townsfolk. But I really want to go over there. Really want to go over there. Really want to go over there. What should I do? No. Oh, okay. Let's rescue the townfolk first. Whoa! Ryan Ironrod. Ryan Ironrod. Oh, hello. Oh, look at him. Well done, Ryan. Nice iron rod you have there. Okay, so just a couple more dudes. And then we should be good. Let's just take out this sketchy one. Frederick, what happened? I've torn and bitten flesh. This recently murdered victim displays remarkably little blood for such a violent death. I wonder why that is. It's been sucked out. Cool. Anything? Ooh, a corner club cavern recipe. Excellent. One more. Towner's focus. Ah, you found a Celeste. You found an amazing hiding spot as well.
Divine, save me. Please, I'll join your army. Really, I will. Just don't kill me.
Okay, what are you talking about?
Oh, you're not one of them, are you?
Technically, yes, but in this circumstance, no.
They just marched into town like they owned the place. That cold, horrible woman. She whispered something to the soldier, and people began to change.
Oh, in what way?
The woman made a strange gesture, and townsfolk began turning into blood fiends. And she just walked away and let her companions... They were so fast, so strong. They started tearing people apart. Anyone who didn't change was attacked.
Weird. I like her. I'm gonna have to find her. Come on.
Other survivor?
Let's get you to the barn. I want to find this woman. She sounds pretty amazeballs. Oh, yes. And then, my friends, Dark Anchor all the way. Right, Adusa, have you sorted your duplicate self out? You have. Well done. You freaked me out there for a minute.
Well, you are gone. We had a few visitors. Nothing Adusa couldn't handle, of course.
Good.
But we shouldn't linger in this place much longer.
So I've got some survivors for you.
Yes. Adusa noticed. Fewer than I hoped, but more than I expected.
Aye.
Meanwhile, this one learned that the vampires left a commander here. He's up in the house, atop the hill.
Ooh.
Moira's hope can never recover while he controls the town.
Excellent, vampire commander.
Mutant vampires require structure. Why is that so surprising? But we have more pressing matters. I will get the survivors out of town. You must deal with the vampire commander. Meet us on the road when the deed is done.
Fine. Obviously, as it goes, I have killed everyone in the town, so you can just walk out. I will happily kill everybody else. The Montclair bastard! Right, we're in. Oh my days. Frickin' loads of. Ow. Right, that's not good, that's not good, that's not good, that's not good. That's not good either. Either. Let's kill that guy quickly. You can get back and have one of those. Oh, who's that? Magician. Bastard. Oh, I'm out of power. No! Right, quickly, let's swap over. Freaking blood fiend now. Let's get some health back on. Thank you. Right, you. Not interfere with matters that don't concern you. Got that? Had to switch to the older, the trusted axe there, probably. Good. Remember them in your death! Didn't he do well? Montclair bastard. House on the hill. Defeats the vampire commander. There isn't a vampire commander. There's a book. Constable's Mordred Journal. Let's have a read of that one then, shall we? I don't remember how long I believed in the principles to protect and serve. Hang on. Yeah, it is. Recent events have opened my eyes and changed so many things, however, I have a new cause to champion and new allies to support. If I regret one thing in all of this, it's that I would now be forced to oppose my dear friend, Adusa Dario. We have known each other for so very long, I find it's always impossible to imagine how she will oppose me. I have vague hope of introducing to a beautiful Leria. Oh, God, you can introduce me, that's fine. Of converting her to our way of thinking, but I fear that my efforts will fail. has well and truly fallen under Verandis' spell. I don't believe that anything I say will change that. I fear that in the end, the proud, powerful Medusa Dario must die. Wow, strong words. Should I record the events to lead to my epiphany? No. Time is short and I have too much to do right now. Later, surely, there will be time enough to fill these pages with the wisdom I have acquired. Suffice to say that Lyria is not a monster. I'm quite fascinated by the woman and eagerly await to spend more time in her enchanting company. For now, let me just write her words and deeds have moved me, that her vision became my vision, that her goals have become my goals, and it all starts here, in the quiet hamlet of Moira's Hope. The townsfolk are either well on their way to becoming blood fiends lords to our cause, or they're dead and dying. Soon we can spread the word of Lyra's blessing to all of Ravenspire. Rivenspire should be Ravenspire, but is actually Rivenspire. And the chaos will be glorious. I really want to meet this Lyra person. She sounds pretty cool. Antisense Dwemna Law. Yeah, I'm not going to read that. I just read a book for you. Not really good about that. Moldred Gang. Ah, good, I've got help. That's always nice. Have some of this. One of those. I can help you, you help me. I'll just poke him. And our good old Moldred will be dead in about 30 seconds. Well played, Ryan Ironrod. I hope that's what the girls call you. Any books of interest? No. So Dusa, she's not doing well, is she? She's like one of her bestest mates. She's stitched. Proper stitched. Where is she? Down there. On the road. No, she's not. She's there. On this road. She's got well out of town. Well out of town indeed. There you are with some townsfolk. Hello!
Ah! By the look on your face, Adusa assumes you were successful?
Of course.
The vampire commander is dead.
Absolutely. His name is Moldred and he is dead.
Moldred?
Oh!
That's the name of the...
Oh dear.
That unclawed traitor! Adusa only wishes she had been the one to end him. You did well, Five Claw. Adusa will see that these people reach a safe haven. Then I have business of my own to attend to.
Yeah, I'm sorry I killed your mate. You fell on my... I wasn't using a sword. He fell on my staff? Not like that. I didn't bum him to death. He just fell... He fell near me. It was an accident. But I'll have... Yep, the Ravenwatch girdle will be fine. Yep, no, that seems... far more appropriate. My inventory is full, however, so you'll just have to excuse me while I just read up on some recipes. And I would love
Moldred,
the Ravenwatch girdle. Seems
there
brilliant.
There's something sinister going on in Rivenspire, Fireclaw. Keep your wits about you and stay fragrant. What you saw here is only the beginning.
Stay fragrant. Do you want me to wear some aftershave? Some, like Hugo Boss aftershave or something? Is that what you're saying? Did they smell? Does it smell?
Adusa will take the survivors to Hoarfrost Downs. They should be safe enough there. Pardon, but this one is still coming to grips with how fast the Blood Fiends were created and with the Constable's betrayal.
I'm sorry.
Yes. Word of what happened here must be carried to my master, Count Verandis. There is much work to be done, and very little time if Lorea has truly...
Lorea.
This
That's a self. Great name, isn't it? Lorea. I want to say it again. Can you say Lorea again? Shame. Probably can't. But, where is she? Where is Lorea? Oh, we've got a few things. A few things to look at. The Atrilock. Should we just go over there and see if we get a bit of experience from going over there? Is it that way or is it that way? It's in the direction we don't want to go. I want to obviously, I'm keen to I'm kind of keen to see if I can't do. Yeah, it's not happening. For whatever reason, that dolmen seems to have disappeared. Right, what's this? Atronach! Increases magical recovery. Don't mind if I do. No. But yeah. I really want to go and kill that kind of gate, but it's just not happening, is it? There's another quest there. It was down here, wasn't it? Agent Grinchman. I don't understand where it's gone, because it was just here. I heard it. I heard you. It's there, isn't it? Dolmen alive! So I might. Ooh. Ah! How many spiders? Ah, there's loads of them! Get back, you fiends! And you, have some of this. Oh, I've run out of magic. Take one of those. You can take one of those. Another one of those. Oh, they're quite hard. They are level 27. So. What? Where do you come from now? That's not fair. It's like literally just rocked up. How can you do that? Where did you come from? Where did you go? Stop feeding on your mate. It's weird. I don't want that. What? No, hang on. There's more. How can there be more of you? There can't be more. Oh my goodness. I don't really don't want to die yet. So, have one of those. Thank you. Right, no more spiders. Good. What's this over here? A freaking massive troll. Right, guys, I think I am going to wait for this dolmen to appear and hopefully get some reinforcements in order to make it happen. And then, yes, and in the next episode, Jamie Lannister and Oliver, Scourge of Tamriel. Womanizer, boozer, all-round scoundrel, rogue, and destroyer of spiders and rats. We'll take out this dolmen. So stay tuned for the next episode. Please hit the like button if you enjoy. Subscribe, loads more content on the channel, and look out for tomorrow for the PvP episode. And hopefully, I'll catch you then. Say goodbye, Jamie. I say goodbye. Anyway, catch you soon, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Take care now.